Soon as I start to record, it's fine. I don't know if you can hear that, but the saw is going. Happy Thursday. I have some time today and thought it's best I run some errands today. Have lots of places to go because on Saturday is our hippo ball or like med prom, and I need to grab some stuff for that that I just don't want to be bothered with on Saturday morning. So gonna run to like Sephora, Target, where else? Walmart. The list goes on. I need to drop off some stuff at Goodwill because I am that person that has had a trash bag full of stuff that I said I was going to drop off and then I just never did. So I need to go drop that off. And Target's right by there. So that'll be easy. And then again, I'll go to Sephora. I'm like trying to map out the route so that I save gas. Sephora, H&M are in the same place, and then I need to drive sort of across town to the African store. And I think that'll be it. So I thought I would bring you guys along. Let's go. I want to pick up a lip gloss that the makeup artist used at the photo shoot on Friday used on me. Well, a different shade of it, but let's see if they have it. So, let's see. I know it's called the Lifter Plump by Maybelline. Oh, this is it. This is what I was looking for, but they don't have the one I want. And Sweetheart. Bummer. KB used this one on me. It's called Taffy. It's like a berry color. That's the one she used. But I was wanting Sweetheart instead. Bummer. That's okay. Okay. But I am going to pick up the nail polish remover pot from Olive & June because I am out. Okay, so that was kind of a bummer. They didn't have what I was looking for. That's okay. I'm hoping I can find it at like a Walgreens or CVS or something. Just because I don't have a really nice lip gloss that is pigmented like that. So hopefully I can find it. I was able to pick up the nail polish remover, so that's a win. But on to the next one. All right, y'all, made it to the mall. I am here for Sephora and H&M. Sephora because I want to pick up some not lip gloss, lipstick. I've had a really hard time finding a pinky nude lipstick that I like, or a combination that I like, but Mally Magic posted a while back some new, I think it's Lip Velvet matte lipstick or something or the other from ABH, and instead of ordering it online, I realized that the color translates quite differently in person from the videos I was seeing, so I just wanted to come in store and like not try it on but like swatch it in person so that I could wear it on Saturday. And then I think I was gonna pick up something else that I'm spacing on, like that's the main objective though, that's why I'm going to Sephora, and then I just need to pick up some random bits and bobs from H&M. So that is the plan. Let's go. Thank you.
So this is Peachy Nude. This is Kissed. I think I like the Peachy Nude better.
Hey y'all, I'm also having a look at the House Labs concealers because I've heard good things. I don't have a foundation shade in this, so we're just gonna pray and hope. Ooh, that is too dark.
I'm done at the mall. As you can probably tell, I stopped recording sort of at Sephora. I didn't really record that much because if you've ever been to Sephora, you know that you just like get lost in the sauce. Like you just start walking down the aisles, looking at things that you don't need. Where did I park? Is it not here? Oh, okay. And then I went to H&M. Didn't really vlog there. The setup, there were quite a few youngins in there. I said, oh no. And then I accidentally dropped the camera on the floor. Gosh, I don't know if you can hear me over this wind. I dropped the camera on the floor and I was like, okay, this is the end. I'm gonna put it away. Anyways, that's done. Now I am on my way to, I don't know, I think it might be easier to go to Walmart first and then to the African store. But I'll show you what I got from H&M and Sephora once I get home and everything. But what I needed, my Bonita Afribalm. Looked up the aisle before I got here, which was super helpful because Walmart's so big, but I actually had it in stock, which is good. And I'll be using this on Saturday, so that's why I wanted to make sure I picked it up early in case they didn't have it, then I could figure out what else I was gonna do with my hair. So let's go. And actually, I'm just realizing that there's a Maybelline stall here, so let's see if they have the lip gloss. Okay. No, so they have the same thing. They're out of the shade that I want. Bummer. Okay. The search continues for this lifter gloss. Okay, let's go. Okay, y'all. All done with shopping. I'm back home. I'm literally just pondering my life because it is downpouring. It started raining as soon as I pulled up to the African store. Thankfully I have an umbrella, but I just don't wanna. It's really downpouring. Hey y'all, I am back home. It is 4:46, so it took me like 3.5 hours to run all the errands. I was doing pretty good on time actually, up until Sephora, which as I mentioned, it's all the minis, you know, when you're about to check out and they strategically place the little aisle of, look at the mini version of this thing that you love, or all the other minis. And then you just start looking through like, oh, do I need this? Do I need that? I didn't need anything besides what I went in for, but that's where I lost some time. Otherwise, everything else is pretty good. So let me show you what I got. So from Target, I originally, again, was going for the Maybelline Lip Glaze Lifter Lip Gloss situation. Wasn't able to find the shade I wanted, which is okay. And then I also had been wanting to pick up a new nail polish remover pot from Olive & June. I like this. I think you guys have seen me use it before. But it's just like a little pot and the polish is in there. It's a non-acetone remover and it works pretty well. Oh shoot, you know what I meant to get? The detail brush, because mine is like a little frayed. It's old and frayed. Darn it. Okay, I can pick that up later. But that's what I got from Target. And then after that, I went to Sephora and I got two things. The first thing I went in for was the Anastasia Beverly Hills Lip Velvet in the shade Peachy Nude, which was the shade I kind of anticipated getting just based off of Mally Magic's video. They had a ton of different colors. This is probably the lightest lipstick that I have. And it looked a little crazy on in store, I'm not gonna lie. But I also didn't have, like, you know, the brown lip liner, which makes a world of a difference. So I think this will look really cute. The plan is to wear it on Saturday, hopefully. And honestly, if it doesn't look great, it's okay. I can still return it, I'm pretty sure. So that's okay. And then I also picked up a little baby version of the NARS concealer. What is it? The Radiant Creamy, right? Yeah, the Radiant Creamy Concealer. And I picked up a mini version because I don't wear makeup all that often and I don't need a full one. Like, this little joint is probably gonna last me for like the rest of the year. And I got it in shade Dark Zero, Chocolat Dark Zero. And I have a concealer now, I have a couple, but I wanted one that was a little bit brighter because right now the ones that I have are very much like natural finish. And this is just a little bit brighter than my natural, like, sort of under eye shade or natural concealer shade. So that's why I picked this up, just to give me a little more oomph. And then that was it. That was it at Sephora. And then I went to H&M to pick up like the most random things. So I got some socks. I don't know why, but I love getting my socks at H&M. I don't know what it is. And I picked up this colorway. I was hoping they had like a brown and white colorway, but it's okay. This is cute too. And yeah, just got those socks. And then I grabbed some silver earrings, which I kind of want to try on right now. I didn't try it on in the store because I don't know if I mentioned it, but I have really been into silver lately, which silver is in. It's a trend, I guess you could call it, but I mean, silver has always been around. And I really don't have a lot of silver earrings aside from the one I got from Lavoot, which I love, but sometimes I want something that's not less dramatic, I guess, than that, but something a little bit simpler. And honestly, H&M makes really good earrings. I've had earrings that I still wear to this day, still get compliments on, that I've had for like 5, 6, 7 years. So I'm a fan. So I grabbed these. And they are lightweight, which I like. H&M also tends to not have like super heavy earrings, which is nice. So this is what they look like. Super cute. I mean, you can't see it when like my face is full on, but I think they're cute. And I also wanted a silver pair of earrings so that when I did want to wear the Lavoot sort of up here is more of an ear cuff, I would have something silver underneath. Because right now I really don't have anything. So that's them. They're super cute. They were like $5. $5.99. So cute. I like them. Then I went to Walmart. And at Walmart, I went there with the sole purpose of getting this Bonito Afro Balm from The Dew. I love The Dew. I use several of their products. This is what I like to use when my hair is blown out. In replacement of like blue cream, I think that's the name. I'll put up a picture on the screen and you'll know what I'm talking about, but it's like the hair grease that we would use. This is a much better alternative. It's water soluble. It smells really lovely. And I actually think they changed the scent a little bit since, no, they haven't.
It smells the exact same. This is the texture. But yeah, this is what I like to use. I got some on my fingers when my hair is blown out, and I plan on blowing my hair out for Saturday, which is why I wanted to make sure that I grabbed it before, because Walmart online said it was in stock, but you never know. That's what happened to me at Target. It said that they had the shade I wanted of the lip glaze in stock, and it was not in stock. So I'm glad that they had it and that I picked it up ahead of time. And then at the African store, I literally grabbed like bread and shiitake because I was out. And that was it. So that is all I got. Pretty pleased with how the day went. I'm kicking myself because I forgot to grab the nail brush, but that's okay. I can still use my current one. But that is it. I'm gonna go eat because I'm hungry, and I'll see you guys later. Saturday. It is hippo ball day. Woo! If you don't know, hippo ball is like our med prom, med ball. Basically, a bunch of med students get together, dress up nice, and have a good time for one evening. So that is tonight. I'm heading over to my friend Tammy's in about like an hour and a half. And so it is time to steam my dress. This is it. It is old from ASOS. If I can find it, I'll link it, but I'm pretty sure I got it like last end of summer / early fall. So this is it. I've had it for quite some time. But yeah, I can't show up with a wrinkly dress. So I'm going to steam that now, and then I'm going to get ready with my makeup and everything. Hair is mostly done, which is why this little wrap is on. But, yeah, let's get steaming. Wash my face. I have just some moisturizer on, and I'm gonna go in with the Bobbi Brown vitamin enriched face base. If you follow Mally Magic, she loves this stuff. I could do without it. Like, it's not do or die for me, but I do have it, so I'm gonna use it. But yeah, how are you guys been? Good, I hope. I also don't really have a mirror, so I'm gonna be looking down at the viewfinder, and also just like some portable makeup compacts with mirrors that I have here. So if you see me looking all around, that's why. So my relationship with makeup, like I said, I don't really wear makeup all that often. I enjoy it. I really, really like makeup. I follow a ton of makeup artists. I enjoy their work. I just find that I'm too lazy to really do makeup all the time. So that's why I really don't do my makeup. But during the, not the pandemic, but like during lockdown, I'm going to go in and do my brows. So I'm wiping off any product because I do have oily skin and that product is just going to make everything slide off. Pandemic, during lockdown, I really took the time to watch makeup artists that were sort of doing lives. I think everybody was trying to create content to help people as they were bored inside or indoors. And I followed a bunch of makeup artists who I still follow today. Delina Mateen? Sorry, Delina. Katie Jane Hughes was big. I love her. I still watch her. She actually has a YouTube channel now. Jonae Williams, I believe is her last name. Ellie Luna. Like all these fabulous professional makeup artists who people pay, you know, like big money for them to do their makeup. We're doing all these free lives. And I was like, you ain't got to tell me but once I'm there. So I just tuned in and watched what they did. And I think overall that really helped my makeup game. But then again, I just don't do makeup a lot because I find that I don't need to, nor do I want to. But I do think it's a helpful skill to have. Just because it's good to just know how to do your makeup how you want it. If for whatever reason, like even if you did hire a makeup artist for every single event, like if something happened and you needed to do your own makeup, you could, you know? So, yeah, right now I'm just going in with the Glossier Boy Brow. Brows for me are one of the hardest parts. I don't have the thickest of brows, as you can probably tell. So some days it's good, some days it's not. It just depends on what kind of day you're having. Okay, those are the brows. Sorry I went silent, I had to focus. I think they're okay for now. I just don't want to get too bogged down because I am on a time crunch. I have like 30-ish minutes to do this. So that's fine for now. Next, I'm gonna go in with the Bobbi Brown Skin Corrector Stick in Very Deep Peach. And I don't have, my skin is overall okay, but like I have some darker spots here and there that I do just wanna cover up a bit. Loving and want more people to sort of get into, well not something, someone, is the artist Ray. I found out about her like probably 2019, I want to say, and I think she really blew up last year. Was it last year? Yeah, for escapism on TikTok. You guys know it, right? A little context if you care to listen. I find myself in a position. The man that I love sent me down last night and he told me that it's over. It's on decision. That girl. I found out about her a few years ago. Have been a fan since. Especially when I found out that she's Ghanaian. I was like, I'm a fan already. Well, she's half Ghanaian, half British. But I'm bringing her up because her Brits Awards performance was fantastic. Absolutely amazing. I don't know why the Grammys, why she wasn't nominated for any Grammys, because she was absolutely phenomenal. She is a phenomenal artist. I highly, highly, highly recommend that you go watch it. In fact, I'm gonna link it down below. That is how much I want people to enjoy her work. It was so good. And I've been listening to that performance, that specific performance, probably at least once a day since she did it. I'm very much obsessed. So yeah, if you haven't heard of Ray, check her out. Again, I'm gonna link it below. She literally doesn't know who I am, so like, I gain absolutely nothing from this. I just wanna put people onto her because she's great. Okay, I'm going in with my Makeup by Mario foundation. This is shade 29C. And I just did one pump because that's all I really am gonna need. Oh, and also more on Ray. this is a Ray stan account now. I hope we all know this. Her acceptance speech was so sweet. Her grandmother, she pulled her grandmother up on stage with her, and her grandmother is a full Ghanaian grandmother. Okay, she had her kaban sleets, or it might have been kente, but it was like up and down. Her name is Agatha. Agatha, but you know, Agatha. And she was just so sweet. I think Ray's middle name is Agatha. She's named after her. And she's just been through so much as an artist that I'm so happy for her to be like creating the music that she wants to, without the stress from her record label. She talked a bit about how, I don't even want to get it, but essentially she's free from her record label. She released her latest album, My 21st Century Blues, as an independent artist, I want to say, and it is fantastic. So just so happy for her, and I just want more people to know about her if they don't already. But yeah, I've been listening to her on repeat. As I really don't do much with the eyes. That's just not my ministry, and that's okay. All right, next I'm gonna go in with concealer. So I just picked up this one from NARS. You'll see it in the vlog, which I think will be up after this. And then I'm gonna also have my Omnicolet concealer. How's that set? I'm good. Why is my nose itching? Okay. I'm gonna go in with my bronzer, get all the skin work sort of done first. I'm gonna just go in with this angled brush, and I'm using the Danessa Myricks. Is it Balm Tour? I think it's called Balm Tour is the name, but it's like balm contour, and I'm using deep 3. This might be the deepest shade, I'm not sure. Thank you. And then for the rest of my face, I'm going to set it with the Danessa Myricks Evolution Powder in the shade 05. Let's move on to the eyes. I am going to be using the Jackie Aina ABH collab. I'm just gonna do like a basic brown, if I can get this to work, brown look. I don't know what I'm going for, but let's just play around. What we are looking like so far. Sorry if the lighting is changing, the sun is setting outside as well. I think it's okay. It's whatever. I'm gonna go in and curl my lashes. My lashes are drying. I'm gonna move on to lips, and lips are one of the harder steps for me. I don't know, I just struggle with, well, I think with a red lip and like a darker lip I'm fine, but when it comes to like a pinky nude lip, this is where I struggle. So pray and hope for your girl. I'm gonna go in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Lip Velvet and Peachy Nude. Me going to check it out. So I'm just gonna put that on. And it's gonna look crazy. Rock with me though. Using a brown liner from Juvia's Place, I wanna say. Okay, I'm gonna leave that for now. And I'm gonna go in with this lip gloss. It's the Lifter Gloss from Maybelline in shade 23, Sweetheart. You'll see the behind the scenes of me trying to find this. I finally found it yesterday randomly after a class at a Walgreens. And I'm just gonna add some like liquid. A brown liquid lip. This is from my friend's brand, So Chic Essentials. I'm just gonna line the outsides of my lips. Yeah, okay, I like it. Even if I don't have time, actually. I really don't. Let me clean this up. And then let's see if the lashes are tacky.
Hey guys. I'm at Tammy's now. I won't show her because she's still getting herself together like me. That's okay. I feel like Shadara was the only one that was actually prepared. Meanwhile, I think I'm gonna go with these earrings.
Funny. Oh, true. Oh, yeah. The arcade was beautiful. I'm like,
No, I'm so happy it's not the arcade.
Oh, you don't like it?
2 years in a row? Like, can we please?
Let's switch it
out. Like, there are more places.
Yeah. If we don't do extra, then who is going to do it?
Listen, we gotta bring it.
We always have to bring it.
Okay, it's downloading still.
This was a mess of a night in terms of, I feel like last year, I was on it. I was on it, and I don't know what happened this year.
I blame the nights.
I do. Let us blame the nights. And do you know what?
Okay, guys, we are back.
This is so cute.
Hold on. Okay, well, we'll come in. They can't see you. We're doing a little post-tipple ball debrief. Sorry for the angle. Mm-hmm. How do we think it went? Because I have thoughts.
What are your thoughts?
Let's start with you.
First of all, I think let's do venue. Venue, I think, was nice, mm-hmm. with the exception of the seating. Mm-hmm. There was not enough seating. Mm-hmm. Other than that, I did like it more than
the arcade. Yeah.
You disagree? You like the arcade better?
I like
the
arcade. I think it's like way nicer to take pictures. I don't know.
I think I like the dance floor better at this venue, at Truce, versus the arcade. The arcade was like, it was crowded. Everybody was.
Yeah, it wasn't stuffed. It was like a hall.
Yeah.
Not hall, but like, it was a narrow situation.
So I like this taste better. But I do understand what you say about that seating, because I was pressed that, like, of 500 people, they had, like, maybe, what, 15? 20 seats?
We never left the seats.
No, yeah. That's why we have to stake it clean.
I was sad.
Yeah. So yeah, okay. Yeah. So we like the venue.
Keith Lee
didn't dislike the venue.
You just prefer...
I just feel like the arcade, like, I was like, wow, the first time I went there, I was like, wow, this is beautiful. It's your second time, I was like, okay, you're used to it. Mm-hmm. But the first
That's
time,
what it is.
I wasn't in awe of this venue. I was just like, okay.
The arcade is very grand. Like, I will give you that. But I think having had it there twice in a row, I was kind of like,
you're over it.
Is there no other venue in this city? So, okay, I like that. What about food? I really was not hungry. I had a Chipotle chicken taco, I want to say. They had tacos, mm-hmm. sliders. What else did they have?
Like flatbread pizza situations.
Mm-hmm. Yes. The dessert. That little dessert table.
Oh yeah, the dessert. The cupcake was good.
The cupcake was really
good. But I feel like the actual taste of the food, again, was better at the arcade.
I don't know.
It was just harder to access the food.
Yeah, I don't know. That's true.
It was much harder to access.
I like that they had different places where the food was, but also I think that it tasted better than the arcade. I'm not going to lie. Maybe I'm not remembering, but
that mac and cheese bowl.
I think that's because you got a mac and cheese bowl. Some of us.
Okay, they ran out of food, I feel. I'm going to take it back.
They went on food. Because
they didn't run out. They kept bringing stuff out. And
that dessert table went crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah. We never had dessert at the arcade.
Never.
Okay. What else is left? Music?
I don't know what the DJ was doing, man. It's not hard to mix, like, into a song, yeah. A, and B, it's not hard to follow a theme. You know what I mean? Yeah. How are we playing?
Going out of my cage and I'll be Mr. doing right just side. Fine.
And then we jump into Drake. I'm like, how did we start? Where is the connection?
Not good.
Like, there was no progression. And then he would start doing the to the next song.
It did not make sense.
He also played like an hour and a half of just pure EDM, which nobody asked for.
Yeah, at some point I was like, I could do better with my Spotify playlist.
Just 100%.
Like, we want to hear songs that we can sing along to. We don't want to hear
Exactly. Like, you have an entire, like, group of people who know early 2000s to mid 2000s music. Yeah. You can do better than that.
So that was, it got better than that, but even when it got better too, it was questionable.
Yeah, not a single line dance. Now that's just me. That
was it, 16 carriages.
No, it was Texas
Hold'em.
Yeah, but none of us. I don't subscribe.
No, I don't.
Never heard the full song, but this man played the full.
He just played the full song.
What's going on?
Which is like, I don't know, because before I used to complain that the other DJ, he was too fast with it. I'm like, let's enjoy the song.
Give us
a bit.
Two verses.
Thank you. Let's
one
get a Goldie Long.
Short whole song could go crazy, but two verses.
Yeah,
the
like
second
a nice
chorus
solid.
Is between.
Yeah,
solid. And then you transition.
Nicely.
The open bar was a nice addition.
It was.
Keep it open.
Was it not? Later. Was it not at the?
No, we had two drink tickets and we were fighting. Oh, I
remember.
Fighting for our lives.
I never ever used mine, so I didn't. Yeah.
We were fighting.
And the drinks were better here.
The drinks were better. It looked better.
Like they were in actual glasses, before they were like a little plastic cup.
Yeah, you got more bang for your buck.
Like if I had actually shown up on time, I would have like six drinks.
Yeah, we showed up right, or like the like bar was
minutes.
Gonna close
yeah.
in 30-20 minutes by the time we showed up, which is okay. That's fine.
Right.
Next time.
Yeah.
I guess that's it, right? Those are all the elements to judge. So you rate it 6-7 out of 10?
Yeah, like 7. The food was good. The drinks were good. I just, like if I had just gotten one more drink, I'd been 7.5.
Okay. They can't really see to me, but that's okay.
Oh, sorry. The food was good. The drinks were good. The vibes were good. I think I'm just much more comfortable. I think in each year, I was saying I know more people.
Yeah.
So I'm just more comfortable, like, saying hi. Like,
yeah.
For me, I like to see familiar faces. And then first year was hard because I don't know anyone to see people in the program. Second year was better. But, like, this year, I felt very comfortable, like, even though, like, not all my friends were able to be there, I felt very comfortable just, like, saying hi to people, dancing with people, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, that's fair.
I feel very settled in our little school.
Okay, what would you...
It was really the DJ for me.
It's
specific because I
only
go
the bare minimum. He was below the bare minimum.
Thank you.
Yeah,
he's
so
bad.
I only go out for two reasons, food and music, because I like to dance and I like to eat. So... The fact that the food was hitting, but the DJ wasn't, it was really doing me somehow. So I'm going to give it a 6 out of 10.
I'm going to give it a 6 out of 10 as well. Because I also like to have a good time. And I felt like I could have had more enjoyment in my house by myself.
I was enjoying more while I was getting ready than when I was at the event.
Right, and that...
Y'all really didn't like this.
That's it.
It's the DJ. I wanted
the
to
DJ. Yeah. I will give him credit in the sense that when we asked him to play a song, he did play it.
He did.
The way he mixed it in was not... It,
it
was rocky.
Nice. It wasn't nice.
But he did play it, so I will give him that.
They need to ask for requests. That's one thing they used to do.
Yeah.
Bring back the request.
If they ask for a request and make a deadline and then have the DJ put it in an order that makes sense, I feel like that would be an overall good vibe. Because usually...
Because people last year, at a certain point, they really were playing them Afrobeats.
They
back
were.
To back to back.
It
was
like,
good.
It was good.
Usually
yeah.
you group things together. That's what makes it a fun thing because you're like, oh my gosh.
Yeah, like you're in your groove. But like it was so discombobulated. I was like... What song is that?
How? It's like my phone was on shuffle. Like,
you're right, it's true. The music being bad does take it to like a 6.
It takes a hit for me.
Yeah. Anyways, that's our little review of Hipple Ball. Not that it will make any difference whatsoever to your lives.
He's Western
but...
Reserve. You know, unless you're coming to
if you see
the...
this, take this advice.
Yeah.
Get a better teacher.
Please.
Yes. Okay. Well, we're going to go. I mean, the night is honestly still pretty young. It's like 11:30-ish,
I'm going to
say.
But we grown.
I mean, yeah. Like, it's... I say that to say, like, we weren't out all night or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
Still
it's
up. We got out at a good time.
After party.
Oh,
yes. There used to be an after party.
Going out to the clubs.
Wow, that was a time. I don't... What is happening here? Embry Center.
Also, we took really cute photos.
Oh, we did. I mean, I'll post it.
The sneak peek, preview.
I mean, I'll post it in the video. Yes, no. Okay, that's it. We're gonna go do our night routines and go to bed.
Good night.
Bye.
I honestly don't know how these clips are gonna all work together, but I have just come home, not redid, but touched up my makeup quickly to finish out the get ready with me portion if I do end up doing that as a separate video. But the night is over. You heard a review of how the event went. This pimple just got bigger and bigger as the night went on, which is fine. The earrings, again, were a hit, and the dress was a hit as well. So I am going to wash this makeup off and get ready for bed. There's church in the morning. And so I don't know if I'm going to end the vlog out here or what, but in case I do, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.